Yeah, what's good with the world? It's your boy, Mr. Wilson. Welcome back to Wilson Block 100 Radio. You know what I'm saying? We blaze the hottest in independent music. We about to give it to you raw, you know what I'm saying? Thank y'all for tuning in. I want to encourage y'all to check out our website, thewilsonblock.com. Please download our podcast. I want to let y'all know, man, you know, we giving you exactly what you're going to download our podcast for. You know, independent music, local artist music. We don't, you know, waste your time with all the commercials. We're not trying to sell you anything. We just want to give you something good to listen to. Hopefully inspire, you know what I mean? And, you know, inspiration fuels, inspiration sells, you know? And that's what we're moving off of. So, you know, without further ado, this track right here is by your boy Scribes from Seattle. You know what I'm saying? It's called Shining Bright. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, this is him on the hook, you know? And it's off of the What Was Lost LP, you know what I'm saying, that you can, you know, get up on the Bandcamp or the iTunes. Just Google it, man. It's on a few sites, you know. Make sure you support and cop that. Get a bar that's great music, and I'll holler right back at you. Mr. Wilson J. Ya.
Wash the pain from my clothes, and I'm sure I'll be. Now I'm real, Holyfield, Cassius Clay, Ali. Like the bad boy of bebop, I mix for a street hop. Was so smooth to see, yeah, was skill tight as P-Rock. Yo, you see these snitches that I have to witness. They all forgiven for their sin, and now they're back in business. Y'all be Hollywood and Cali, acting like John Voight. Then front and walk a mile, they'll style Detroit. But I ain't focusing on dealing with the Doberman, but rather showing everyone the love that I hold within. I plan to move, never live locked down. From hoods and city blocks, burbs to college town. Shit, I feel trapped and closed in crab pots. I pick through closed doors like pins and padlocks. I plan to ball, man, you all coming with me. I climb beyond the walls of my city, come get me. Cause I got thick scars, bright lyrics, tight bars. About 100 hot writtens, 2 records, 5 stars. 9 lives, 1 soul, but I still can't sleep. Live and work till I reach 6 feet, gotta hustle. Cause I got thick scars, bright lyrics, tight bars. About 100 hot writtens, 2 records, 5 stars. 9 lives, 1 soul, but I still can't sleep. Gotta work till I reach my peak, it's a struggle.
I want all this time to stay. If it's all to shine my way, so when it's all over here, I'll stay shining bright. Cause I want all the sun to stay. If it's all to shine my way, so when it's all over here, I'll stay shining bright.
Life's a bitch and her armpit stink. She gon' shit up in your bath, then vomit in your kitchen sink. She'll take your money, use your bed, and leave you fucking lost. And when the shit becomes unbearable, she'll suck you off. I know the balance and the real equation. I hear the rappers and the jockeys talk about it now on every station. Some on top call me hip-hop, the truth talker. Some around call me Motown, the groove doctor. I wanna walk within the widest oasis and elevate the levels of my lower life to higher place. I think about it all the time. They say if I forget about reality, yeah, then I'll be fine. But they don't want what I want in life. They wanna dodge the bother, the hardship, they're probably right. I put my little slang on it, they want it. I plan to change the game, hey mama, you can bank on it.
Cause I got thick scars, bright lyrics, tight bars. About 100 hot writtens, 2 records, 5 stars. 9 lives, 1 soul, but I still can't sleep. Live and work till I reach 6 feet, gotta hustle. Cause I got thick scars, bright lyrics, tight bars. About 100 hot writtens, 2 records, 5 stars. 9 lives, 1 soul, but I still can't sleep. Gotta work till I reach my peak, it's a struggle.
I want all that sun to stay. If it's all to shine my way, so when it's all over here, I'll stay shining bright. Cause I want all that sun to stay. If it's all to shine my way, so when it's all over here, I'll stay shining bright.
Yeah, everybody gotta go sometime, right? Only so much control that you can have over the situation. It's like, man, you put in all this time and you pay your dues and go through all these hardships and struggles, man, that really only God can understand or witness. grips with the fact that you might die unacknowledged or forgotten. You know what I mean? But whatever the case is, you do your best to finish the type of goals and dreams that you want to accomplish, and that's all you can do. You do the best you can.
In a pit, and I made it without flipping a cent. Spark my bang with a flip from the bit. I should never have to pick between my dog and a bitch. But in the yard, it ain't hard to get caught in the mix. You felt pain? Tell me how I feel to get shot in the dick with some hot shit. Callus on my hands and feet. Won't be another bing bing after me. Unless it's my seed, hence the name Lil Bing. You'll sing well after the year 2015.
You struggle with me, I struggle harder. Sipping champagne, I'm still off that faucet water. You say you struggle, for me I struggled harder. You eating gourmet, I'm still eating out the garbage.
Just got the call, baby mama on the way. Funny bitch lying, cause I know the game she love to play. But anyway, that's a problem for another day. As for now, I'm trying to find a way to bubble, man. Take life for granted and see what happens. Asking questions is better than guessing and not passing. About to drop like hot acid. See, now that y'all laughing. Kid, I hear your boy being broadcasted. Got blisters on my feet for sleeping on cold concrete. Since 16, I've been all ROP. Never catch a nigga chucking up a ROC. Black tea, summer heat, come fuck with me. I'd rather smoke a couple blunts and go get a job to get by a couple months. The man in the front, he got slapped for your trunk. She won't fuck, that's a bulletproof monk. Bitch, get your ass up.
You struggle for me, I struggle harder. You sipping champagne, I'm still off that faucet water. You say you struggle for me, I struggled harder. You eating gourmet, I'm still eating out the garbage.
Something apart, these dudes fucking with narcs on the grind like that man on the moon. Yellow whip speed like Pac-Man on the moon. I ghost your whole crew when I'm clapping out the roof. Look, that mean the top is rag when I pop the mag. After that, go to Macy's and pop some tags. Hit the club, find a dime so I can pop some ass. Most niggas trick, they go out just to cop some ass. Handcuffing hoes in the room, trying to cop the ass. Like that's the precinct. Don't she get a phone call? She ain't getting shit, but dick bubbles on the full wall.
Dina, I got a pound of dope. Catch me blowing smoke down Pharaoh. Cause we the Dina Stars. And you know I got a clown of hoes. When I see him belly down and throw, we still living on the day to day grind. Hustling by the ABE. Cypress, top to the low. Stomachly in the temper. From the projects all the way to the end.
It's the money magnet cash through. Absolute soldiers treat a bitch like a card game. Guaranteed to poker. I be that ace and spade and y'all jokers. Haters try to get me mad, but I keep shit kosher. Toaster on my waist, no holster. The wrong mover get ya. Brains on the wall like a poster. Smoke doja, eat shrimp and drink Folgers. I smash whips with no L's and hit donuts. Serve smokers, them big rocks, my stones boulders. Time bomb chicken, waiting patient to blow up. These niggas working with the law make me wanna go nuts. Fake answers, they be acting like they so tough. They really snitches, cops send them on missions to get donuts. And we holding mags the block, we got it rolling fast. Hang with dudes that sling and bang like shoulder pads. Ray Lewis, nigga.
Don't Lincoln with a nigga bitch in my car, so my pants keep sinking. No tense, bitch, give me top by the steering wheel. Leaving dookie stains when I peel. That skid marks from the wheels. I got the yak on chill. You try to jack, I might have to clap like seals. That's that steel. Been years since I wrestled. Let's get to the point like needles and thin vessels. Take niggas' bucks and coach them like Jim Tressel. Slang swag bags at 3 for 10 special. I used to keep rocking the pocket like Drew Bledsoe. For the Cavalier, I was whipping the Swin special. Now I get top before the hoes say hello. And I don't even ball, you dig? They just maul the kid. My ball's so big that you can get a running start and bungee jump off my dick.
I got a pound of dope. Catch me blowing smoke down Pharaoh. Cause we the Dena Stars. And you know I got a clown of hoes. When I see him belly down and throw, we still living on the day-to-day grind. Hustling by the ABE. Cypress, top to the low. Summit land and pepper. From the projects all the way to the east. We the Dena Stars.
Yeah, you already know it, man. If you ain't noticed, nigga, just ask around. Sometimes you just gotta take a deep breath and shit, man. Shit be fucked up out here. You gotta, you know, keep going. Check it, yo. Yo. Frustration of peace, police butt rape in the streets. Fucking goons pumping cases, just eat. A lot of niggas facing defeat, tears from the struggle. Perseverance, exercise your mental muscle. Lyrics humble to stress, spirit tussle with flesh. Though I'm scientifically powerful, rhymes infinitely shower you. Picture me cruising down Malibu in the silver Bentley doing 60 on the avenue. Get yours, cause I'ma get my birthright to have the world made a booth be my shrine. Hope I don't have to go back to moving dimes. Crime, I have you by a rope, I'd rather poke dope lines. Rockin' shows, Acapulco Golden Optimos. Time to hide his flows, watch my pockets grow. Breath is freedom, so inhale deeper. Gain your mic, my nigga, don't let life beat. Take a deep breath, feel the air in your chest. Inhale the peace, and exhale the stress. On these streets, it's easy to get vexed. So when you without the luxury of money and sex, just take a deep breath, feel the air in your chest. Inhale the peace, and exhale the stress. On these streets, yo, it's easy to get back. So when you without the luxury of money and sex, just take a deep breath.
You with the program, cadet of the arch nemesis of Uncle Sam. Quick to charge you like a ram. Life is a test, one hard exam. Took the pen out my text so this shit don't jam. Rastafari, like the soul of Bob Marley. Trying to guard me from my goals, catch shots like Ron Hardy. Go to the wake and tell your mom sorry, then drop a Cardi. Ghetto terrorists that'll bomb the Republican Party. So who the fucking harm me? One man army, swam in the ocean of daggers, still couldn't scar me. One day my last smoke became a wise ghost. Said those who won't find heaven be those who cry most. So I boast about the shit I got under my wing. Blood of a slave, heart of a king. Breath is freedom, so inhale deeper. Gain your might, my nigga, don't let life be. Take a deep breath, feel the air in your chest. Inhale the peace and exhale the stress. On the streets, it's easy to be vexed. So when you without the luxury of money and sex, just take a deep breath, feel the air in your chest. Inhale the peace and exhale the stress. On the streets, it's easy to get vexed. And when you without the luxury of money and sex, just take
sometimes
a deep
sometimes my
breath.
Mind feel locked in, body boxed in, chest wheezing, fiending for oxygen. Frown beyond my false grin, emotions all bored in. Back against the wall then, a Mack truck backs up to smash me. I didn't die, so it's gonna make me stronger, no lie. Longer 4-5, damage all, camouflage fit. You go through odd shit, but that's how God get eyes dry. Retaliation from a drive-by, that's why it's difficult for my folks to rise high in this world of sin. I fight to get the pearls and gems. Large stacks, cars to match the girls and rims. Weed smoke be the potion of bliss. Help me relax when my motions are stiff. Breath is freedom, so I inhale a deep one. Gain your mic, my nigga, don't let life beat you. Yeah, like that, like that.
So I won't hold out. Infinite knowledge flowing from an open mouth. Gifted one of God's children, I'm spreading my wings. Use talent and experience, get the maximum green. Hijacking your dreams, won't study the scheme. Thinking what's more important is your shoes and your jeans. Used to say a nation of millions would hold us back. Yes, we still reeling from the effects of crack. Go deep within my thoughts, grab herb out the jaw. And the first words I scribbled was fuck the law. Drawing strength from my roots and my heritage. Exuberance of a rookie with the polish of a veteran. Dre Harv and all bold lettering. Keep it on the marquee at your favorite stadium. With all due respect, wanna see what's next. Get busy living or prepare for death.
Dre, here's how they gon' come at you. With the rats, trying to distract you. Dre, here's how they gon' come at you. With the rats, trying to distract you. Dre, here's how they gon' come at you.
Expect the next chapter. Who's the best rapper? Yes, after this, no one else matters. Blood froze, heart exposed. So I had to give you a dose in the form of this poem. The haters keep me hungry, so it's making me fatter. Heaven comes first, but I'm bringing hell after. Mic in the booth, go straight to my brain. Like they shot the beat right up through my vein. Wanna be a hero, all muscle bound. When it comes to fighting for people, it's muffled sounds. Stand out, what I'm saying is so profound. Want more out of the game than just a local crown. I guess that's the reason I'm getting so vocal now. In case one of my colleagues wanna show out. Yapping on my Twitter and Facebook. And get your face cut. Bars like bullets to change how your face looks.
Dre, here's how they gon' come at you. What's the rest? Just trying to distract you. Dre, here's how they gon' come at you. What's the rest? Just trying to distract you. Dre, here's how they gon' come at you. What's the rest? Just trying to distract you. Dre, here's how they gon' come at you. What's the rest? Just trying to distract you. Dre,
hey Dre, man, forget all that Michelin ass, Relly ass, Firestone ass niggas, man. They tired, man. They tired. Hey man, this took your bank, man.
I've been a G since a youngster. People try to call me hater, never once was. Got my mind on my paper, always focused. Yeah. The hood be trying to pull me back in. Want me to be the me from back then. They be like, Dre Harv, what happened? Yeah.
your bars not factual. I guarantee you live in the hood, every stack they taxing you. Maneuver around these potholes, assist from Paco. Make sure that it's hot though, make another one pronto. Mind bending, rhymes written, no nines hitting. Just descriptive compositions on how mine get it. 16 bars, check how my mind kill it. I've been diagnosed, I guess I got rhyme
fitness. Here's how they gon' match. Silly rap, who's trying to distract you? Dre, here's how they gon' come at you. Silly rap, who's trying to distract you? Dre, here's how they gon' come at you. Silly rap, who's trying to distract you? Dre, here's how they gon' come at you. Silly rap, who's trying to distract you? Dre.
Yeah, yeah, what's good with it? It's your boy, Mr. Wilson. We here live on Wilson Block 100 Radio. We got your boy, Jay Mays, on the block with us today. What's good?
What's good, man?
Chillin',
man. Appreciate it.
Man, glad to have you here with us, man, for this exclusive interview with the Wilson Block.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, man, just so for our people out there listening, man, give us a quick little background on yourself, man.
My real name is Jamil William Mays, man. I came out here in Pasadena as a youngster, man. I've been out here since I was 3 and a half. I got adopted, you know, out here. Uh-huh. Appreciate every moment I got adopted out here for, man, because I wouldn't experience the hardship, the pain,
right.
The stuff that you hear in my lyrics. I wouldn't experience that if I didn't live in Pasadena. You know,
right.
It's the city of its own. Everybody think one thing, but you come to the city, you know.
Right, exactly. So you were born in
Torrance. I was born in Torrance, okay. Raised out here. I'm adopted. I got a twin brother, a half brother. We born the same day, same time, and everything. Just, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
We became bros up in there. Since he stayed in there, you know, shouts out to him, Rod. His name is Rodney, but. You know, I've been rapping for about 11 years, 12 years. I've been doing this since, like, 2001. Started off at Longfellow Elementary. You know, I got to get shouts out. I've been doing it. Start off my nigga Taz on the beat. Start off with Young Fizz.
Taz. I went to Elliott Whitting.
Yep. Shout out to Fizz. I'll start off with Fizz. That nigga, I don't know if I'm saying it right. Holly Valens. Holly Valens. Yeah. My boy Devin. Yeah, I was grew up with I did start off with him.
Okay.
My boy TJ, you know what I mean, from the East Side. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I start off with, a lot of niggas who still doing their music, so niggas know about me.
Right.
So
what type of artist are you?
I'm a hip hop artist.
Okay.
I've been studying hip hop since I started rapping, because I picked it up from I was like a class clown, a goofy dude, but I was quick, spontaneous.
Right.
And I was able to write poems, and I had a creative mind. So the teachers was like, why don't you just try and branch out? And I ended up having my beatboxing take me to my freestyling, and then from there I went to my rapping and my writing and everything.
So you used to beatbox?
Yeah.
Let me hear a little something. Oh, that's wet.
You know what I mean?
That was dope.
Crazy shit, you know?
No doubt. And see, that's how I know you used to do that, because you was just, you get it, as soon as I asked, you know what I'm saying? That's dope, man. So tell me a little bit about some of your projects, man. What you got out right now? What's upcoming, you know what I mean?
Okay, you know, I got Go to State of Mind out right now.
Is that the one you just gave me?
That's the one I just gave you right now.
Okay.
That's the exclusive joint. That's 11 tracks. 12 tracks or whatever, because I got the intro in there.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But it's 11 tracks. Okay. I should have put the other one on there, but that's what's going on in the project. I got to save my talents and stuff.
That's right.
You know, it's out right now. It's been out for a while. It's streaming around. You know, it's cool.
Yeah.
It's a wonderful project. Got in my heart and soul. I did this like a hard time in my life. I wrote a lot of these songs, and these songs come from my past, and they bring a lot of memories up when I made them, and along with the beats, I make the beats myself, so you feel the hardship and pain in my beats as well.
So you produce your beats?
Yes.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
And what do you use?
Fruit Loops. I finally got producer edition. I used to use Fruit Loops 10 demo. Fucking demo, so.
Right.
Excuse my language.
Wow. So you producing your own stuff.
Yeah.
You writing your own lyrics.
Yeah.
And you can freestyle.
Yeah, and
you got the best of all worlds.
trying, man. I did it because I know, growing up, man, I really had too much influence around me that was positive, and had too many people that was going to help me out without giving them something back.
Right.
So I had to teach myself how to make the beats and teach myself how to be humble and wait for it.
Yeah.
And it took me about 11, 12 years.
You know, that's inspiring for me. You know what I mean? Because I realized that, you know, I got to sit down and make my own beats. I can't be waiting on these cats. Because what ends up happening is, you know, as much as I like to write music, I'm writing music to cover songs. So I'm spilling all my stuff on the cover stuff that I can't even resell.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
And by you producing your own stuff, you're actually entitled to more.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
And producers, you know, typically make more than the artists.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I mean?
That's why I do it. And I did it, you know, I'm very independently minded, man. I did it solo all my life. And people know me for being solo. If I'm with somebody, it's either me and that person. It's not going to be me in a crowd. You know, I'm not a crowd dude. You know, I don't do all that, man. Yeah.
Just straight to the point. Boom,
yes,
boom.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. No doubt. So life is about.
All right, so what's coming up? I mean, you got Golden State of Mind.
I got Golden State of Mind out right now. I got Flexing coming right back. Coming right back. I was called Flexing. I call it that because it's going along more along with the new mainstream as far as the wordplay go, as far as flexing. That's the word they use as far as niggas perpetrating the front and acting like they real and all this other stuff. And that's you're going to hear that in the songs. You know what I mean? Right. I talk a lot more on actual points rather than my thoughts and what's inside me. I'm actually give you a solid point, concrete statements that you can actually put down and hear. You just don't listen to the lyrics anyways.
Right.
So you got to put a hook down and a good beat, you know, and then you got to go with the rest, you know. That's why I put flex in and get a little catchy little hook, and I'm 23 years old, so, you know, we getting older, man. These dudes getting younger, and they're getting younger in the game, so we got to got to stay with them, you know.
Exactly. So tell me a little bit about some of the performances you've done. Of course, we saw you at the Loft the other night.
Yeah,
you know
thank you for the support, man. Thank you for support.
You know, you broke hiatus with that. You know what I'm saying? And we was actually able to document it. You know
exactly,
what I mean? How was that experience?
It was actually nerve-wracking to me because I'm used to going up there, showing out, doing me, bouncing out, and then, you know, and then come back and do some other stuff because, you know, people just feeling me or whatever. Right. But now I came back. It's been a while, man. Yeah. And
how long are we talking?
It's been a while. It's been 2 years. It's been 2 years. Since I don't keep no secrets. I've been in rehab, man. I was clean, sober 2 years coming up. Thank God for that.
Amen.
I messed up a lot, so I couldn't really stay focused on the music because there was a lot of things going on. My dad passed away and all kinds of those things. So we moved. That's why, you know, my roots is for the pen. That's why you see a lot of stuff about Pen Block on my records. That's why, you know, you got Wilson Block from the Pen Block.
Yeah.
I grew up on that. So, like, without that, you know what I mean, I didn't feel right. So I had to go to rehab and get myself right. So it's been a while.
Yeah.
And that was my first actual performance. I recorded a song, all my beats, with me in the back, you know what I mean, with me spitting.
So you produced those songs, you recorded them.
Yeah.
Hey, man, I salute you, bro.
Thank you, sir.
For real.
Thank you.
It ain't too many local artists that I come to an interview and they already done stuff. Mm. They already, you know what I mean, set up to where they can, you know, they're in full control of their stuff.
Yeah, exactly.
And when I come across that, you know what I mean, because I keep it real with you, I didn't know. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, this is pretty insightful for me, too.
Yeah, that's why I tell everybody I got beats by the pound, man. It's just when you inquire, people don't inquire the right way on some occasions. They inquire with ulterior motives, kind of. You know, you hear all of my mixtape out, but they're like, oh, nah, but what about the beats? But like, nah, you can't support. You know, it's free, you know.
But
I'm doing this, you know. But, you know, hey, you can't knock nobody for that. So I make beats as well.
So you know for other artists too?
I do for other artists as well. Okay. You know what I mean? Right now I'm producing for Swag B. I don't know if you
Swag B.
You know,
shout out
it's
Swag
my
B.
Big bro. It's my, big
it's my
bro.
Boy.
Yep. Yeah, shout out to that nigga. He coming out with what did he say? He's coming out with Cowboy Up.
Okay.
That's his first. That's
Cowboy
his name.
Up.
Cowboy Up. You know,
I'm about to holler at him about that.
Yeah, yeah. I'm gonna tell you to come up here, man. Holler at y'all, man. And I'm producing that. I got my wife. You know, spoken words. You know what I'm saying? So. With a Z now, with an S, because I don't want y'all to think it's just all about that. She's deep. Yeah, she does poetry.
Oh, wow.
Spoken words. You know, you get in here, you know, she'll tell you some things, man.
Oh, man.
I produced for them, too. And I produced tracks for Freight Quality coming out. I produced tracks for the whole team, Roses, the Roses League.
Uh-huh.
I shot some tracks to Big Banks, Kawan, Young Wolf.
Yeah.
I got beats out there with Cats.
These Pasadena artists?
These Pasadena artists.
Oh, what?
We got KO, okay. Pasadena artist KO, Big Bangs, SCKSA, everybody know that.
Okay, yeah.
Gave him his, I got shot him some stuff. Frank Quality, of course, he out here with the Rose League. You probably heard of him. We got the Pigeon Store down there.
Uh-huh.
Cool Pigeon, shots to them cats. I just produced them some tracks. I think I was going to give you some tracks. We just hook up. I've been kind of wiry, man.
Right,
stringy.
Right.
I shot a couple other cats some tracks, like some cats from out of town. Like my cousin, he from out here. My cousin Face, he back out rapping again. I gave him some tracks.
Yeah.
So my music is widespread, and I got different varieties of it. It's not one
sound.
Yeah, exactly.
Right. So tell me about the different types of genres.
I do every genre due to the fact that I listen to every genre. You know, and I grew up around it. You know what I mean?
Right.
I grew up around white boys. In Pasadena, we're cultural. We're culturally
very
diverse around here. It's not just black dudes. It's white boys and Mexicans, and they talk like us, act like us. We cool. We got people right now that, to this day, we still You know what I mean? Even if whatever color you bang, whatever side you from, whatever you from, we still cool. We see each other, different race, whatever. It's still love.
Still love.
And
that's what it's about.
Yeah. And you know, and I came up with that. You know, I used to hang out with white boys. I used to hang out with, and I used to listen to their music, and they deep. The white boy, he's real, like Nirvana, and you listen to Door. They deep, man. Yeah, they telling you some stuff. And you listen to the beats, and it's interpolation in the beats, and, and imitation and all that. You get the, I'm deep. So, you know, from there, I could put it in my head from one of my beatboxes or one of my creative, you know, minds going off, and then, bam, put it down.
Right.
You know,
so are you using any?
No machines, okay, no controllers.
No external MIDI. No,
I had external MIDIs. I used that, and I learned that that kind of limits you in a way because you got the padding, and if you can't sit there and be the patient one, go through the channel, go through the pads, hear every effect, hear every sound, chop it up, do what you got to do with it.
Right.
And if it's, you know what I'm saying,
it's like
to me, I like my raw samples, raw basses, put it in and then cut it myself.
Right.
Put my own this and put my own that in there, and with no controller, I get more hands on with it.
Right.
I can get more creative with the controllers. Right. It's controller.
Right.
So it's boom, 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 boom. It's just give me this, give me that.
Yeah.
With mine, I can create this, I can create that, and I can control it, mix it around, move it around without having to spend time on a controller.
Right.
If it break, like my last one died on me, it crashed.
So you had a keyboard?
I had an MPD.
Right, MPC.
MPC.
Right.
I had the MPD too. I had the MPD and the MPC. The MPD is the drum pads.
Okay.
For reasons. You know what I'm saying? I got to put my boy Mercy Marsh up to him. I produced him some tracks. I also gave We55 some tracks too.
Shout out to him
too. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Some of my rail too. But back to the subject. Learn that you get it crash, hard drive, internal memory, it gets you to spend more, you know, time on the craft rather than spending more time on your creative art. Because, you know, you spend more time producing, it's going to take 10 days to make one beat. You want to mix it to be out. And if you
doing
get a
all
deal,
the technical stuff.
Exactly. Right. When you get a deal, you're going to, they want you one out this time. They want you to do this, want you to do that. You got to be on point.
Right. It's business.
Yeah. And I made different sounds. I know different people come along. Like, you got a different style than anybody I heard before. That's why, like, man, my nigga Bing Bing Hall. When I heard you, wow, we went to school forever.
Right.
You know what I mean? And Swag B got a different style. My wife do, me, you know what I'm saying? KO, we got, so it's different styles to where it's like, help me up, it give me a challenge.
Exactly.
And it give me a place to fall back on, because, you know, nowadays, your lyrics may not get you to the top. It may just be your beats.
Right, yeah, exactly. Because, you know, and the beats is one of those things that, because it is, you know, that first thing that people hear, you know what I mean? It's that attention grabber, you know what I mean? Then, you know, it's you got to have that one.
Exactly,
you know
what I mean? You got to have that one.
Yeah,
and exactly. And with your lyrics, it's like nowadays, you either got to dummy down your lyrics if you got bars, or you got to put just straight punchline after punchline, make it to where it's catchy enough for somebody to catch it. Because nowadays, if you don't dumb it down, lyrics don't get across too much.
Yeah, people ain't tuning in.
Yeah,
because you know? The attention span of,
exactly.
of people these days, is, especially the young generation.
Exactly. And they looking for a club, beat, dance this, dance that. I want to hear a new fad. That's why, you know, in the rooms I went in and I called you, it's all in society now. They teach you to stay down, stay submissive to their forms of fashion or lifestyle, living, you know what I'm saying? If you want to drink, you're going to drink. Or just drink all day, drink all night. That's songs now.
Right.
The kids saying it. You know what I mean? I'm hearing kids reciting songs that they're not supposed to be saying.
Right, exactly.
When we was kids, we had Pac, we had Big, we had really, I saw my girl, it's really 90s. If you wasn't hard, you wasn't going to come out.
Right.
If you didn't have bars, you wasn't going to come out. You were going to push back until 2000 sometime then.
Right, exactly.
Because if you're in the 90s, everything was, you hear it in the lyrics. You hear the difference.
Yeah. You actually had to be good.
You had to be good.
And you know what? I think after the year 2010, you know what I'm saying, just to conclude that decade of 2000 to 2010, in music, it actually showed that the 90s was the golden era.
Exactly.
In music.
Exactly.
You know what
I'm saying? Point blank.
Yeah, exactly.
As far as what we're doing.
Right.
Because I know in the 90s, you know, the 70s, the 80s.
It was still hot.
It was
hot,
of course.
The funk, the neo-soul, you know what I'm saying? You can't take that.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But with the 90s, as far as what we're doing,
right.
that was the best time, you know what
right.
I mean? And people always say we were born in different eras as far as 90s babies go. If you don't hear that a lot, you kind of, I don't know.
Yeah.
But they hear it a lot. Like, from older cats, we hear a lot of 90s babies getting stuff like, oh, you were born in the 80s, but you reincarnated, or you was a king back in the day. They tell us these things because that's the golden era. We was in the golden era, literally, because you know, that's everything was different. Then. Right. The cars was different. Everything that the society was different. Minimum yeah. wage was minimum wage. It was middle class. Nowadays, middle class is lower class, exactly. and lower class is
yeah.
gone class. You know what I'm saying? Like, I got a job right now, yeah. man, and I'm working 26 hours overtime every week just to make the bills.
Wow.
Ends meet, man. It's wow. like, you know, and everybody doing out here, people talking about they picked the craft up just yesterday, and they got a hit. It's like, man, it's kind of...
Yeah. Right. How?
How?
You know exactly.
How? And
they working
how?
For everybody that
exactly.
easy.
Exactly. You know how? Well, people like us, we out here on the streets, we hungry, we seeing you... You artists too, but you won't support us, but we at everyone in your show. We right. record everything. We looking out for you, but you right. can't give us the time of day.
Right.
Only because
right.
you got a name or, you know, it's just right. it's weird. Right. It's weird.
Yo, yeah. Speaking on that, and I might have said this in another interview, but that's why I like the city of Seattle, because you got the top artists, and they collaborate with the small
exactly.
artists.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Like your boy Macklemore.
Mm-hmm.
But, so, with that, what are your views on the current state of the local music scene in Pasadena?
It's scattered. It's scattered due to the fact that people got they house cliques now.
Right.
Like, kind of like the South. When I was living in Texas, the same way. It's like, you got your same clique you're going to click with.
Right.
And if you can't mess with them dudes, you're not going to branch out.
Right.
Or if one of your clique members don't get along with a dude you're trying to branch out with, it won't get you nowhere.
Right.
It's driven, you know what I mean? It's not driven by, a lot of these dudes is picking up nowadays. You know what I'm saying? I'm just putting no specifics out there. Anybody, any city, any town, they's picking yeah. it up nowadays. And it's a craft, man.
Right.
So when you pick it up and you get people like us, and we're not, you know, with everything you with now, you're going to, you know, it's a problem. You right, know what I mean? Right. And it's like, right now, it's scattered, you know?
Do you believe that we could have a united local
scene? Oh, we have a united local scene when it comes to a mutual agreement. Uh-huh. If we all agree to just say, fuck it, we're going to have some fuckery going on. We're going to have some fuckery going on. We're going to boom. We're going to go to the club. We're going to go to the party. All Dena. Right. We're going to club it up. Right. And have a good time.
Right.
But if we all choose to have some problems, we're going to go out there and we're going to mess the club up.
Right.
You know what I mean?
And rather
it's happening. It's happening. Right. At people's right. shows, homies trying to put their showcase out there. It's homies that right. put flyers on people's page, you know, free shows, and there's no support. Right. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
And then it's like, it gets to the point to where it's like, okay, now it's like beef. Now you done messed with this dude. Now it's right. back again to the conflict again.
Right.
Pasadena's only so big and so small.
Right. It's a big, small town.
It's a big, you small town. Because yeah. people don't know it cut off at Woodbury. That's
right.
not
exactly.
us up there.
Yeah, people forget that.
It cut off. So it's not as, we're not really that big as far as big time artists. Like, we got people, you know, we got people that rap.
Right.
But
I mean, but you fuck with
Cassie. Yeah, of course. Dena, period.
Yeah.
But it's like, it gets to the point to where it's like everybody got their size now. And it's like, I'm going to push my product rather than, well, if we come together, we'll be stronger than anybody because right. you think these L.A. cats, they pushing together. They may yeah. come in beefing or whatever, but then, you know, they're going to come together some yeah. way, some form, they're going to come together.
Right.
How was it that Snoop Dogg on the song with that dude, Psy, the fool, don't even Gangnam Style dude, how was it that he on a song with that? But it's like, we came to a song with each other. We live next door to each other.
Right.
But yet, if we go to jail or with a pen, we're going to ride with the same people we don't like in the streets.
Exactly.
And it's, you know,
it's twisted.
It's twisted up. And music is not music anymore. It's like our music, it gets to the point to where it's like, okay, it's just, this is write some shit down and this is record this.
Right.
You know, the homie got a microphone, let's record. Because if you notice, you go to the studio, 9 to 10 people you go to the studio become rappers.
Right.
And they wasn't rappers going in.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Man.
They was somebody else before.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But they come in, I can do that. We do some bars.
Right.
I could do all my team. Right. This is somebody. You
it's
know,
that typical
it's
ass.
Typical ass, ass normal. And it's like everything. Then you hear it again in another song. You hear it again in another song.
Right.
Same verse. They all heard the same.
Right.
He dope.
Right.
You know, and it get to the point where it's like, okay, let me just stick to my roots. And you be one of them artists that's just 40, 50, still with a craft.
Right.
Still trying to get on, you know?
Exactly.
That's why it is them artists that's old, that we call old, but they've been working hard, man.
Right.
You know? But it can come together, you know? Right. And we're just right here. I love this right here, man. This is wonderful, bro. You know, I'm envious of this, man, because this is something that we could have been did, man.
Yeah.
This is the best place for it. It's in Pasadena. It's for my Pasadena artist, person who's an artist himself, who's seen the other side. It's a good thing that you've seen, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
you're just an interviewer. Like the Alcoholic Anonymous, you just be a counselor. You learn from the book. You don't know about what we went
What's
through.
Going on.
Exactly.
Right.
You went through the music phase. You went through the production phase. You went through the sitting in the studio, blank mind, like, damn, I gotta think about this song, man.
Exactly.
The days when you go back and you put your mixtape down, you're like, they ain't still here? Oh, man. Or you cross my, you hear my mixtape? Oh, I didn't get a chance, man. You're like, okay, you read them days.
Right.
Them days
when
you ain't got no money in the pocket, but you're still going to the booth.
Right.
Still chasing that dream. Days where you go to the show on the bus, getting off the bus on the show.
Exactly. You know? I like to call that in the trenches.
Exactly. You know in the trenches, getting it in. Excuse me. Yeah. In the trenches, getting it in. Because if you don't do
in
like
the trenches,
that,
you you still in a position of you got to survive.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Head on the swivel at all times. Exactly. We in the jungle out here. People don't know we in the jungle out here because there's so much tension besides our music. That's why you hear about getting artists come with that. We got to come with that gangster twang. We got to come with that stuff on some tracks because we lived it.
Right.
We got to walk. We had to walk past these gang members to go home. Our gang members was our family. Had to come in there and see them with other gang members in the house.
Right.
Our best friends was them dudes that's filling them pens up now.
Right.
Or filling them graves up, man. Rest in peace. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Our friends are the ones that's on the news. We hearing about laying people down and robbing. It's like, wow, man.
Then throwing their lives away.
Exactly. It shouldn't be that we 23, 24, and we got obituaries longer than our parents' lifespan stretches.
Right.
You know what I mean? We went to, it's people who go to funeral homes, they know us by name. We not even, you know, we not the one in the coffin.
Right.
You know, it's a shame, man. And it's like, and get to the point to where it's going to always come back to that.
Right.
But if people ain't here to house that, like as far as what you're doing, house that, bringing in, like we're going to all do it like this, man, make it like that.
Because
it is music at the same time it's creative.
Yeah.
So you can go out of your craft. People don't want to go out of their craft and go out of their nature. I'm a gangster, I'm a gangster.
Right.
I'm killing, exactly.
You
instead of expanding, it's all the same songs.
Right.
That's when you get no disrespect. That's when you get people like the Gucci Mans and the Walkers, the guys who got one style.
Exactly.
And it's trap.
Yeah.
Or gangster, like Snoop.
Yeah.
Gangster, the original Snoop, all gangster rap.
Yeah.
Original 90s, dudes of the 90s, Dr. Dre and them, all gangster rappers. What? They couldn't branch out because what you going to rap about?
Exactly.
If we rap about girls and clothes, we lying now. We purpose
I think the 2000s really kind of showed that other genres can kind of fuse. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
With like Nelly and Tim McGraw.
Exactly.
And
like I said, Snoop aside, that new dude, Gangnam Style dude.
Exactly.
Speak English.
And then Snoop and Katy Perry.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
And that, California Love.
You got that. You got, you made that song with that dude who sing. Phil Freeze and his own.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Song with that dude. So it's like you know what I mean? I made songs with dude like Frey Quality. We got heat melodic with his tones, his tempos. I'm straight to the point of mine.
Right.
You know, it's different arts, different places, different talk. Go to State of Mind, you're gonna hear that too much more. You're gonna hear a rapper like Ding Ding, you're gonna hear a rapper like J-Maze, you're gonna hear rappers like Swag, but you ain't gonna hear that out in San Francisco County.
Right. Exactly.
Pasadena. You know, we got our own swing, our own lane. That's why I said if we come together, we'll win.
Exactly.
And taking our twang every day, you see cats with Obvious, Giant shirts on, Dina Boy shirts on, people wearing our swag, people walking around in our gear, people using our twang, and we can't do nothing about it because we won't come together.
Exactly.
And if we do, it's going to be just for that moment because somebody forced us because there's money involved.
Right, right. And see, one thing I did notice on the Pasadena music scene is that a lot of the camps around the scene and in the city, let's say, like, you know, you got Paco, you know what I'm saying, and you got, you know, Sneed and... You got
that teacher. Whole camp. He's been my teacher when I was
younger. Oh, Sneed?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, no doubt. Shout out Steve Sneed.
Yeah,
you know
sir.
What I'm saying? Got much love for y'all. But you got a camp like that where, you know, they put out, Sneed put out an album where it had Pasadena artists on it.
Yeah, yeah.
And it was pretty diverse, but it was all within that camp. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly. It was no others.
Right, right. So until Pasadena, because it's not like local artists ain't working together.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
It's not,
but what needs to happen is the major movements that are going on need to recognize each other.
And come together.
And come together. Even if it's for, yo, man, let me get that mixtape cover. Let me get that feature. Let me...
Exactly.
You know,
a feature,
I'm going to come to your performance.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
I bring my team, you bring your team. We got 50 dudes, we got 50 dudes. Me, I'm independent so much that it's just me, my wife, and Swaggy on Dead Broke Entertainment. Was Dead Broke Entertainment... Apologize, just some dudes in Minnesota. They got that label.
Oh, so yeah, you got a record label.
Yeah, a record label was going to stay. It was Dead Broke Entertainment. But I just recently found
Dead
out.
Dead Broke Entertainment.
Yeah, it was somebody else. But it was my thoughts was thought different than white boys put. Some white boys put it down there in Minnesota. Shouts out to them. They got Dead Broke Entertainment. You got that. You patented that. That's good. I didn't know y'all dudes. I made that in 2001, man, because you never can have enough money. That's why I say burn money on one of my songs.
Right, right, I remember.
But my new is called Go to State of Mind Entertainment. I call that because the name of my record label, but it's also I got to go to State of Mind, man. You know,
definitely.
I keep it that way. It's Go to State all day. I don't think out of the box, out of as far as where I'm from, as far as it's Cali to the death, man. You know, I can't go out of my element and go down south and make some down south records because I'll be out of my element.
Right,
I won't be counting. I tried it in Texas too many times. That's why my style's different.
Right.
But it's go to State of Mind Entertainment.
Now, do you guys have like other artists signed to it?
We got Swag B right now. That's my big bro. We just think day one with it. I got my wife, Spoken Words. We've been married 2 years. Jessica Perry, her.
Congrats.
Thank you. I got my production team. It's just me, But I got an alter ego, of course, like, you know, Beyonce, Sasha Fierce.
Right. Wayne, Mr. Wilson.
Exactly. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? That's your last name, too, for real, ain't it?
No, my last name
Taylor.
Is Taylor.
Yeah, okay, I'm tripping. My bad. Excuse me, sir.
Well, you know, I grew up on WilsonBlock100.
Yeah, so, exactly. You know. That's perfect. But then mine, I got Ghetto Symphony. My partner, Brian Carter, gave it to me. Shout out to my boy, Brian Carter, Fruitless Man.
Yeah.
He gave it to me. He said, I got a Ghetto Symphony. And I didn't understand that until now. That's really a Ghetto Symphony because it's not, you know, machines, not synthesized, it's not mixed down, it's not cut, it's not premeditated before you guys get to your ears. It's just straight cut from JMA's head to your speakers.
Right.
If you choose to put it in there.
Exactly.
I love my music, man. I love the people around me, as far as the people I keep around me, as far as my music, man. I love everyone around dealing with their music, man.
Yeah.
It's positive, man. Yeah. It's a good thing, man. I'll be making, doing something that don't got to do with basketball or football.
Because
our talents branch out. We don't think they think black folks just do one thing. You know, we do everything, man.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, I taught myself everything. Taught myself how to record, taught myself how to rap, taught myself how to write, taught myself how to make beats, everything.
So nobody, speaking of that, who influenced you coming up as an artist? You know what I'm saying? Like, who are some of the cats you looked up to?
When I was younger, my favorite artist was Eminem. Eminem. My two favorite white boys is Eminem and Vanilla Ice. I have Vanilla Ice to the extreme. That album was dope, man. People don't understand that, man. That album dope. Boy got bars. Huh. He's got work, you know, as you do when you come in not humbled.
Right.
But them two dudes, because they was out of the box, they was white boys. And then I didn't know they was white boys until I looked like, what? What is this?
Right.
And I was a kid, and I used to listen to, I used to think of my mom, text my mom about, my mom was white, by the way, and I'm adopted. My all black records. So I hear the Chronic. I'm 9, 8, you know, 7, 8, hearing the Chronic, hearing Gangsta's Paradise.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Tony, I'm hearing different music.
Right.
Tank, I'm hearing Usher's first. So Eminem caught my eye the most. And Pac, of course, caught my eye the most. And then I got KRS-One, I got my EPMDs, I got my Eric B's and Rakim's.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? They influenced me in the beginning. And then I had to go back and listen to them again because I started listening to my BGs and my Wayne's.
Right. Started getting a little older.
Got my little other. I started listening to the beats more again.
Right.
And I got back to my craft and listened to the more KRS-One, you know, and the Conscious Daughters. I got all kind of Mac Dre's and different artists for the fact that they have different styles.
Right.
And they got their own style. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
But my biggest influence, like I say, is Eminem. And my biggest influence as far as doing what I'm doing now, as far as my music going now, my pops. Rest in peace.
Oh wow. Yeah.
Because, you know, he taught me to work hard and take care of what's right. So I take care of my family, you know what I mean?
Right.
My wife motivated me, my son motivated me, my dad's what put that in me as a kid. So he the main contributor to all that you see now.
Yeah.
That's why in some of my songs, you'll hear a lot of deep messages going on in there. That's why that's my Eminem part of me. Then I get my, you know, my Cocky Waka or my Gucci.
Right,
you know,
right.
We got different personas.
You're reaching out to the different graphics and whatnot.
Exactly.
So expect us to listen to it and write the review.
Exactly.
All right, so we're going to do that.
Exactly.
So for sure. So where does you get your inspiration from when you're writing your songs? Because you freestyle, but you write too.
Yeah. My inspiration comes from my writing. I go in there. I get it from my son. I get it from my wife. I get it from my thoughts of my niece, my sister, my past, the messed up past.
Yeah.
Those who I lost, and I usually not to be cocky, I get it from others. You know, I go listen to your stuff and try and kill you. I get it from your stuff and try and kill you.
Right.
You know what I mean? So I go to the person that I don't like in the industry and listen to his stuff and I'm like, I'll kill that dude. And I end up freestyling and I end up having to write it down. I see my hand moving on the pen and pad like magic or something. I write the whole song.
Thank you.
I don't like writing in phones. I like using pen and pad. I'm so old school.
So
that,
conventional. You gotta be conventional.
Yeah, conventional. Because when you get the phone, it could die, delete.
Right.
It may not get your words right. You forget it, and thoughts come and go.
Yeah, and that's exactly why I got back to the writing.
Exactly, and that's where you come from. But my inspiration, like I said, comes from my past, and it comes from a lot of what I went through, and what I've overcome. Man, you know, I went through a lot. So.
Right. So. You know what I'm saying? As you progress as an artist, you know what I mean? And you get to, you know what I mean, a wider fan base, you know? What are some key ways you would give back to the community?
First off, first thing, I got this already in my head, man. I went to a 12-step anonymous for 2 years straight, you know, against my will, as I so-called called it. But it was my will that took me in there.
Mm-hmm.
Getting people back on their willpower. You know, a lot of people don't got their willpower no more. Oh, the bills are due. I can't. Oh, the rent due. What am I going to do? My lights cut off. Oh, Lord.
Right.
You know, and so you're so bad. But yeah, it's people, it's always can be worse.
Right.
And it always can be 10 times better off if you wanted to. It's just what you do. Your willpower is gone. Right. We took it away from us. And these new medias, these new societies, these new websites to where everything is online now. So our willpower is gone. We just go online and find a job.
Right.
Before, we had to walk on that pavement, pound that pavement, go talk to the manager,
submit that application,
and get an interview that same day.
Right.
So you got to go in your interview clothes. Why are we walking through Dean in hot, 100 degrees? You know, but first I'm going to do, I'm going to house a community organization where it's, regardless of what you do, regardless of what craft you got, if you a musical, any type of musical type of background, any type of anything, you come in there and you got a place to house your craft, where you learn the real basics of it. Because me, I never had a chance to do it. And I'm just so, I don't know what it is, but I'm good, so I don't need it as far as right now until I get that level and it's called for it.
Right.
And to where I can get them in an actual studio setting. Because it's a difference between a house rapper and a studio rapper and then a real rapper.
Right.
Real rappers can go anywhere and shine.
Right.
You go on a stage, in the middle of Times Square and shine. Right. And we from Dena.
Right.
You know, go in a box in the middle of Colorado, in the middle of the street, hold traffic up and got a bullhorn.
Right.
Go.
Yeah.
You know, so I'm trying to get them to feel being in the studio, being on that time schedule, being on that... This is my business, so let me put my money up, and this is what I'm paying for.
Right.
Let me put my best out.
So you actually want to help local
artists.
Up and coming local artists.
And then get also come together as far as all the big guys who fund everything as far as the CEOs of the companies come together, and we put together little venues for them to have chances to perform. Kind of like Villa Park. Like Villa Park, I used to box out there.
Uh-huh.
So that kind of stuff works. The exhibition for the whole city, free this, free that. Job fairs where... Those who are starving artists, those who have crafts, those who go to school, those who do things and they can't get a job because they get so much into their other things, you know, you don't want to, never want to kill your craft. Never kill your craft. Have a sweet source forever. You go and you can get a job that fits your criteria, that can fit your time.
Right.
Go, we have those programs where those who, like it's female out there, like my wife and my sisters and my cousins that are influencers that can sit there and speak to younger women, younger kids, and sit there and hold seminars where they speak to those who are troubled, you know, those who need the help and speak to those free of charge and get that inspiration and get the numbers, get a chance to collaborate with us as far as big name artists, guys who got names in Pasadena, collab with us and get a chance to see how we work, you know, get a chance to, you know, do all that. Reopen up, like, back to gyms, the gym opened up most of them, put gyms back in the city.
Right.
We got Villa Park now and Jackie Robinson. Put a gym back at Washington Middle School.
Right.
Put a gym at, you know, we can put a gym in Washington Park, refix the parks up.
Right.
You know, every so often throw free shows, you know what I'm saying? Come together and come together with our own fun, throw together free shows, put raffles together for the kids, teach the kids the craft. 8 and under classes or 10 and under classes where we teach the kids the craft where workshops exactly where we working hands on with you and they see how we work, how we write, formulate classes, how to write, freestyle classes where you can get a free verse class where it's just off the top of the dome where you learn to do that because that's how you went from freestyle, you learn to write.
Exactly.
No learn your history, put more musical programs back in our schools where it's not just, because I learned from Miss Abbott, you know, at Washington Middle School, you know, cadence and all that. We learned to dance, we had to do it. We had to cook, we had to do all that at Washington.
Right.
We'll put them back in schools where kids learn to do the thing they need to do as well as what they want to do.
Right.
Because what you need to do is not what you want to do. What we want to do is be all-stars rapping. It's not what we need to do.
But you got to know those fundamentals.
Exactly. What we need to do is buckle down, do this, do that, you know, do Bing Bing, do J-Maid, and do it how we can. Because, you know, it gets to the point to where we help others out so much we can't house ourselves.
Exactly.
And if we can't help ourselves, it's like, who going to help us?
Exactly.
And come together more on some diversity stuff to where we can branch out to Spanish artists as well.
Right.
You know, like P-Boys, his name P-Boys, that's the name LP, dude from Big O and M Records over there on Summit and Penn. I think his name is LP Boy or something like that. His name is, excuse my language, I know who you are, man. I just got to think of your name, you know what I mean? But he got some stuff too, he got some heat. He's Spanish though.
Right.
You know what I mean? I got my boys, my team cream potters over there on Almighty Pen Black, my boys, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Chip, Monkey, they flow. Frey Quality and Spanish cats.
Yeah.
They flow. We need to come together with that and get that going, you know what I mean? And get all that, get it housed in one place to where you have to come together. Like Wu-Tang said when he was younger, we didn't like each other until we came to the booth. And then we had to get along because we got to make this money. And you come along, you know, everybody's favorite thought is money.
Right.
We're thinking about money, money, dude, stop everything and go to money.
Exactly. Exactly.
If we tell them we can get some money off of this, man, come to do this thing for an hour every day. You got a place where we housing it. We funding it and everything is free of charge. That'll give you the tools you need that we didn't have as artists.
Right.
To where we can do what we thought we was going to do. You know, everybody talk when they ain't got it. And then we get it, oh, man, they forget everything.
Right, right, right.
And it's like, you know what I mean? We can't. The city's so small, we're so big, and we got so much talent out here.
Right, right.
That's why you see HS on TV performing with them big schools. We a little tiny little school, so-called, but we win the tournaments.
Right. You're talking about
Mir. The band, too. Both bands.
Right.
HS, too, be over there touring at the Disneyland and all that.
Oh, wow.
They be everywhere with it.
Wow.
Mir, of course. You got the alumni band. You know, we can bring them out and give them places. Have venues like this where we can actually have the artists get used to interviewing.
Right.
Give them chances to put on the producer, the CEO's pants and ask them, what would you do if you had a label? Let me see. Give them a workshop where, okay, I'm going to take you home. This is your project. Make a record label and put all your points, your selling points, how you can get yourself across, your business models.
Right, exactly.
Everybody, so that way they can be business minded. Right. So when they get there,
it's not nothing new.
It's not, yeah, it's not familiar. Exactly. It's not the sign of your soul. It's not the sign your name here like Aladdin in the blood. I'm like, oh, why is it in blood? But let's know you because you didn't know what you was doing.
Right, exactly.
You know, it's fine putting everything. You know what I'm saying?
You didn't read what you signed.
Exactly.
Right,
And with that, with us doing that, we'll be better off as artists. You know what I'm saying? Because I'd rather be an artist than not to be.
Right.
You know?
Yeah. So yeah, man.
That's a lot.
Yeah, that's very insightful though, man. That's a lot of local artists should take note. You know what I'm saying? And they got to know, man, that you know if you know what you see on TV is a product of business.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
And hard work.
Exactly.
And that's what's based on business because you know you learn that like Wilsonblock didn't start yesterday.
Right.
It took time.
Right,
I seen your come up.
Yeah.
I seen from the Bing Bing posters to the. Oh, the what's my number going to be? And then next you know, boom, we here.
Right.
You know what I mean? It started off with the Jay Zillas. I was Jay Zilla prior to this. It started off with the Jay Zillas after my boy Bobby Matthews. Then it went to Jay Mays after my boy Esco gave me that name for playing football and basketball.
Yeah.
But it evolves as you go, and it's hard work. You strive better. You go from making a boom, boom, boom to a. And then go from that to and then cut it and make it to where you go to that auto tune. You get to that and you get to the reason. So now you got 10 programs just for producing on your computer. You're like, whoa.
Yeah, just for one track.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
You got 10 people on your phone, missed calls from all artists that want to mess with you because you didn't work your butt off for this.
Yeah.
And it's to the bristle with it, man. It's never stops. Music, you can keep music on a train. You get inspiration. Right. That's why I walk and I talk to my son even though we can't. He don't talk as we talk.
Right,
he
can't hold the conversation.
Exactly,
yet,
he's speaking his language, but that's unique to me because he got his own world. My wife got her own world where their kids are just, and if people do the thing, it's just, it's crazy, man. Right, it's crazy. Right, music is limitless, man.
Yeah. All right, yo, man, we're about to run out of time, but before we do, man, you think you'll hit us with a little freestyle?
Oh, man, I said I could hit you with a freestyle, hit you over the head, call it lack band or liposuction because I'm taking it out of them. I'm running in like a center, but remember the centers? Now they not no more here. We got liquor, but we don't even drink. Sometimes we pour it out for dead homies, and they don't even think. Back in the time when we used to bleed with these cats, see with these cats, and sleep with these cats, but never thought to be back on the same plateau. Plateau is my state, so I move back. I'm on slow. Everybody smoking now. They only smoke right. You smoking that grade D. I'm smoking grade A when I'm on mics. I'm taking flight. 1-2 to the third power. Square that up. Now I'm going for an hour. You cowards devour. This taste is really sweet and sour. Oh no, do I gotta leave you coward? In the corner, big coward. The stealers that I take on. My casterly, casting seeds. Got them fools casting the different things of casting leaves over you like cast of seeds or castaways. Team and MCs don't want to speak with me. You speak to Wilson in streets. You dudes is Tom Hanks on beats. I'm like, run away with that old thing. You can call it Forrest Gump. I got that fried shrimp. I got that fried shrimp. I got that baked shrimp, I got that cooked shrimp. I just love shrimp. I get it in, I dip it in. I get my money how I live, it's my dividends. I got my dude Bing Bing to my right and my left be my spirituality. MCs can never take it out of me. Battle me, you get battered and beat. Battered and bruised MCs don't know problems about me. Please.
Thank you.
Not even that sense,
hey, man. Just watching you freestyle, man. I was taking low-key mental notes. You know what I'm saying? Like, okay, he's just keeping it going. He's not allowing himself to fall off.
Exactly. You got to keep it going. That's what it is, man. That's what it is. You always fall off.
Right.
Even if you're writing, you can sit there and be like, right, I'm going to run. But, oh, no.
Right.
Whoa.
Hit that block.
And boom.
You know
that's when you hear somebody be like, oh, no, he didn't do that. Right. You hear somebody break it down on you in a song. It's always there, man. Right. We never perfect, man.
Right.
Wayne got blocks. Dre got blocks. Right. Everybody got
exactly.
We human.
Even man. The greatest, right.
Yes, sir.
All right, so, yo, man, you got any shout-outs before we cut out?
Shout-out to my wife, Spoken Word. Shout-out to my son, Velva. Shout-out to those who came out and supported, Kiva and Kobe. I appreciate that. All my heart. Shout-out to Miss Tripp. Shout-out to Bing Bing, of course. You know what I'm saying? My sir, Mike Taylor, his real name is Dude Like That, because we're going to keep it 100. We're going in around here. Shout-out to my big brother, Brandon Loudermilk. Shout-out to Swag B, of course. Shout-out to my boy, Kawan, of course. He's part of the production in Pasadena as well. If you need beats, hit KO the Wolf up as well. Shout-out to my Mun, Edie, and Tate, ENT dudes, Marky B. Shout-out to Jay Banks. Stay out this time, fool. Shout-out to my boy, G-Dev. Hope you not in there, man. I ain't seen you in a while. Hit me up, man. Shout-out to Riley Deuce. Forgot about you, player.
Yeah, G-Dev.
I'm still there.
I see my
G-Dev. Yeah. My G? Okay,
about
okay.
A month ago.
Exactly, okay. Shout-out to Mr. Ryan, his mom. I love you, dearest. Shout-out to my mom. Shout-out to my poppers in peace. You know what I mean? Shout-out to my sister, Sarah. Keep your head up out here. It's a struggle. You know, it's hard. Shout-out to my brother-in-law, Ashley. Keep your head up out there, man. It's hard as well.
Yeah.
And shout-out to everyone in Pasadena that's doing what you got to do on a regular basis. NOI, you're my boy. I see you. Zone, I see you too, man. Zone. Big Banks, I see you, man. I'm going to shout-out to all my cats, man. V8, I see you, man. I really see you, boy. We55, watch out for that. We Sachi, man. That Walking Around Money is what it's called, I think, in Boss Hog NT or Money Hogs NT, Beat Bums, all that. Boy, he got it locked. You know, shout out to my big homie, Relly B. You know what I mean? That's pretty much it, man.
Yeah.
Pretty much
everyone
it,
else
man.
I forgot.
And everyone else, yeah, man. You know what I'm saying? God bless, man. Yeah. And
all right, so look, no doubt. So before you just tell people where they can find your music,
mm-hmm.
Can you let me know how you spell Jay Mays? It's just
J-A-Y. The little loopy line. M-A-Y, dollar sign.
Okay, got you. Got you. So
that's my name is Jamil Mays, so it's actually I can't take no copyright involved in that.
Right, thank you. And if you put that little thing in there, then can't nobody mess with
yeah,
you.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
So where can they find your stuff at?
You can find me on Hawkshare, man. I'm still J Mays, J W Mays, or I'm Dead Broke NT. That's gonna change pretty soon, so guys get it now if you can. It's on my Facebook as well. You know me by Jamil William Mays, so go to that, and J Mays is in the quotations, and it's right there. The link is right there.
Yeah.
When bam, Hulk Shock, I got my own radio station as far as I don't know where that's at, but you type in my name, and it'll pop up, J Mays, with the hyphenated and dollar sign, it'll pop up.
Yeah.
It's 11 banging tracks produced by yours truly, Ghetto Symphony, J Mays, of course. That's pretty much it. You can find me anywhere, and I got them on deck all day.
Thanks.
You know, you can find me anywhere. So, shouts out. That's it.
For sure. Jay Mays, man.
Thank you, man.
It's been an honor for having you on the block with
yes,
us,
sir.
Man.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, man. We out. Wilson Blak 100 Radio.